All right, so I guess we're going to get started. Joining us here in the audience are the ninth grade class from the PTech program. Welcome, guys.
Do you know that the president actually went and visited them?
I heard about that, yes. And we have their IBM mentors here as well.
That's
so nice. How was the visit from the president?
What was he like? That's got to be fun. He's a good guy.
He's a good guy, yeah.
So he's a pro-science guy, I got to tell you.
The great thing about the PTech program is it provides students with the opportunities to earn associate degrees and gives them a shot at getting jobs in partner companies like IBM.
That's right.
And we are very proud as a company to partner with the PTech program, and we welcome you all.
So I think what happens first?
What happens first is we're going to actually invite two co-hosts from PTech. So let me just get their names. Diamond Williams and Angelo Lizardi. Are they here?
Oh my God, they're dressed up.
Welcome, guys.
Welcome.
Want a pickle?
No.
Oh, come on. All right.
And they're going to be joining us as co-hosts for the entire session as we talk to the various distinguished guests that we have.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
So,
I would like to ask a question to Ijeoma.
Ijeoma. Sure. Go ahead.
What's the biggest risk you ever took?
That's a tough question. Wow. Okay. So the biggest risk I think I took was actually, interestingly, joining IBM. IBM's a great company. Now, let me provide some background behind that. I earned a PhD in chemical engineering, and my thesis was focused actually on biomaterials, so I was actually going to go to a pharmaceutical company. And I learned about opportunities at IBM, research specifically, and it was in a completely different area from what I had studied, and I said, I could go into and work for a company like Pfizer that I know a lot about, and I know my research will have direct implications on, or I could join IBM and work on packaging, which I'm not really sure I know a lot about, but I know I have the fundamental knowledge and skills that could contribute there. So I chose IBM because IBM research is a distinguished institution, and it's the best decision I've made. So it was a risk worth taking, and I encourage you all to be open to taking risks that pay off, because I think they do.
We're glad you're here.
Oh, thank you.
And John, I have a question for you. You're an IBM fellow, and I was told that there's less than 80 of them in IBM, which has over 400,000 employees. You have more than 50 patents issued or pending in the field of design automation, methodology, and circuits. You're really smart. So did you really eat a rat on TV?
I sure ate a rat. Yeah, so you know what's really interesting? You talk about taking risks. So he asked me, did I eat a rat on TV? Well, technically, no, I didn't eat a rat. I ate a lot of rats and pigeons. Yeah, well, let me tell you, what happened, this was about 4 years ago, but you asked Ijeoma about taking risks. And sometimes you just got to change it up a little bit, no matter what you're doing. So you're working on one thing, and I wanted to change careers. And being an old guy, I was like, it's hard to change. And I got a call, from a Hollywood producer saying, essentially, you have weird hair. Do you want to be on TV? And that's essentially what it was. And it was an engineering show on Discovery. And it was lame. The show was really lame. It was called The Colony. But I took a leave from here, and I spent 59 days living in a warehouse making stuff. So it was a big junk pile, and we had to figure out how to make electricity and pure water and weapons. That was the fun part. But we didn't have much food. And for 32 years up until that point, I'd been a vegetarian. And so my first red meat was rat. But it's really good. And I tell you, when you're hungry, we ate pigeons, we ate rats, and there was one point at the end where there was a dog walking down the street.
Oh, no.
And we didn't catch him. But,
okay, good.
But anyway, the main point I'm saying is I think it goes back to
no,
the question.
It does.
It's about taking risks.
Yeah.
Because that was the most fun thing I ever did. I ended up getting to build stuff every day. It was really fun.
And I think the other thing that that's highlighted by our answers is the great thing about science and engineering is you get to work in very different areas. You know, just applying what you learned in math and the different sciences that you take, you can apply it to very different areas and have fun in each of those different areas.
So. And it's interesting too, because the problems, it's not like, you know, you teach math, maybe you teach it now and you go say, what's the answer in the back of the book? Real engineering or stuff like on that show, there was no answer. You had to figure it out. Sometimes you had to take risks and make mistakes and actually get it better. It was, that was great.